Cleveland Clinic Florida provides individualized treatment plans for excellent outcomes of health problems, ranging from the most common to the most complex, even in cases considered untreatable by others. Cleveland Clinic Florida, every life deserves world-class care.
Well, hello. Welcome to Monday in the KBJ after the show podcast.
Yeah.
What's up, everybody? Here we go. Hope y'all had a good weekend. Good to get back. It's going to be a weird week.
Yeah.
It is.
It's already feeling weird. Feeling real weird.
But you felt weird last week.
That's a good point.
Yeah, so what's new?
I just found all my Uncle Sam costumes, Coach. If you want one, I have three, and I realize each year I forget that I buy one from the year before. And I just got three Uncle Sam costumes now.
Yeah, you did. Okay.
And I found my bikini.
His thong.
My thong.
He's got a man thong.
Oh, wow, you do.
You do. God bless this great country.
Mm-hmm. God bless it.
Everyone. Is that what you're going to swim in for our swimming competition?
I would love to. That's getting some traction, by the way. Three people on Twitter were talking about me and Virginia swimming against each other.
You got three, huh?
So it's definitely happening.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's big news for us. Yeah. Well, we're going to be doing back-to-back cocktails and karaoke. Did one Friday in Boca, and then this Friday we're going to be in West Palm Beach.
It was great fun.
Yeah, thanks everybody that came out.
I'm embarrassed to see the West Palm bartender.
You should be.
After what I did to him last time.
But I'm also embarrassed to see the West Palm Beach sound guy after what I did last time. So we both got our crosses to bear.
We left a trail of destruction in the West Palm Blue Martini, and we're sorry.
When Kevin's not there, man, it falls to shit.
Got a little crazy,
well,
huh?
We feel like we need to step up our performance.
Okay,
so
yeah.
So instead of, like, three people there giving you goods, you only have two people there giving you goods.
Yeah.
So me and Jaybird overcompensate.
Okay, you go the crazy, yeah.
I mean, we did.
Yeah, the videos I saw, pretty impressive.
Look, not to say Friday night wasn't awesome either. Me and Caitlin from KVJ Nation, we got down and dirty.
Pretty impressive dancing, yeah.
Sexy.
Pretty impressive dancing. Yeah. Diane sent some photos. She was out there on Friday.
Nice.
Thank you very much. Good seeing you out there. Just one of the many people that were there. So hopefully see you all out this Friday. Yeah, I assume a lot of people doing their own little fireworks thing. Somebody sent an email here about 4th on Flagler. Bearded Mexican said, hey, I'm sending you this email because I want to know if you and the gang are going to be there at 4th on Flagler. It would be awesome to see you guys and buy y'all a drink. Yeah, I don't know. It probably, you know, the only thing for me, it is weird with it being on Wednesday. You know, we're going to go ahead and work on Thursday. I was looking at that. It doesn't seem like a lot of people are taking off Thursday, Friday. So we want to be, you know, where the people are going to be. And if they're going to be at work, then we want to be on the radio. So, and for me, I'll be asleep before the fireworks kick off. It's going to be, the only thing is kind of a pain in the butt, though, because everybody's got their own little homemade fireworks stuff and dogs are going crazy. And so.
You'll start to hear them going off today, actually.
Yeah, probably.
Today being July 1st.
Yeah. It's the 2nd.
Mm-hmm. Today being July 2nd.
Thanks for playing.
Yeah, it's July 2nd. It's World UFO Day. You didn't know that?
Oh, World UFO Day.
Yeah, it is.
I did not know that. Mm-hmm. What a fucking poser I am.
Right?
You don't know the date? You don't know about aliens?
I thought it was tomorrow.
Yeah, World UFO Day. It's a big one. We'll blow that. Curtis from the Pizzle said, what's going on? Virginia seems like she's a little bit off with some of the games. She couldn't exactly remember the rules for the Rat Traps or concert tickets game. And it just seems like she's lost a step. I'm kind of concerned.
Sir, she's drunk.
I'm just getting old, I think. I don't know. My memory's not what it used to be, definitely. I struggle with memory issues.
Well, in your defense, we do have three games for whatever reason. They're all similar. They're not similar when we play them, but read my lips. I can't even think of it. Read my lips. Think fast. I always fucking think slow. Thinking about
so ironic that was. what was holding him up. Think fast.
I like that he's trying to defend me and help me out, but he just tripped and fell.
Yeah, I'm defending you, and then, of course, you still make fun of me. And never mind. I don't even know what the fuck I'm saying. I'm so tired from my air condition not working. I didn't sleep very well last night. So I'm in a really weird space mentally.
Mm-hmm.
I slept too good. I was having dreams about John Mayer, and I did not want to wake up.
Was it a
sex dream?
No.
Love dream.
We were friends. We were hanging out. We were doing this beer tour together where we were going around to all these. We were on a trolley car. It was very bizarre. Then we went back to this house that was, I guess, my house. And he was just hanging out and everybody was just buddies. It was very sweet.
Mm. Sounds lovely.
me and Kevin completely... We dialed out.
Yeah, that woman that was upset that we'd posted the upside down bikini photo earlier. She's on a tear today. She didn't like your.
Oh, she's back for more?
Yeah, she's.
What's she saying now? She told me this is what she told me last, that I better watch out because I work for a company.
Watch out? Like what? She coming for your job?
I didn't say anything rude to her. Everything that I said during the email, I honestly would have no problem saying that to her face. You can't make any jokes in text anymore because everyone thinks you're being serious. I mean, I was being serious, but I was kind of trying to have some fun with
it. Well, she had just, we had posted up some girls are taking their bikini tops and they are flipping them upside down. And so, you know, they're wearing them in the opposite direction. Now, and so her thing was, she said, look, this is inappropriate, and you need to take this down off of Facebook. You know, and I just told Jaybird, I said, well, I'm like, you know, the only thing about that post is it's still a bikini. It covers the same, like if you said I have a bikini, and they were all normal, regular bikini tops. And if you say, look, my bikini top covers 60% of my breast, it still covers 60% of the breast. It just covers the top half now over the bottom. There's no pink part showing and nothing along those lines. So, you know, to me, if you can post a bikini photo on Facebook, and you can, last time I checked, right?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
All I do, this is exactly what I said, because she's like, you know, take it down. I put, I'm sorry you're offended. It's the same amount of flesh that is, if it would be upside down. There's nothing sexual about it. It's just a bikini. Thank you. There was nothing mean about that.
Yeah.
And then she comes back. You don't care about kids, and they don't see if you don't care if they see this stuff and all this stuff. So I just said, ha 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 ha. Sorry, you're offended. It's just a bikini. Stay away from beaches.
Yeah, and so now.
Then she posted my rudeness. She got me.
Yeah, she said, because Jaybird put, you can post whatever you like, because she said, I'm going to post your rudeness everywhere. She said, post whatever you like. It's just a bikini, and thank you for sharing our content. That helps us out greatly. She said, I sure can. It's America. You look so foolish. You really should watch it. You represent a company.
Oh, my God. She is going off. Girl, you need to simmer down. Go have a little oolong tea and relax.
I don't like this whole thing. Just because you work for a company, now you have to fucking pussyfoot around. I can't have an opinion now, or I have to take shit from
well,
people?
It's the dangerous thing that's happening, where it's like a minority of people or whatever. Or you provide a little bit of content, and it's the minority of people now. One person is outraged. It's the outrage of America. It's like, because I am so outraged that I am going to be able to shut you down, and I'm going to get everyone else outraged, and we're going to make you cower to our silent majority venom. And it's really annoying, and it's just gone too far in our society. And it's like, look, slow your roll. Yeah, to you, and honestly, what it is, if nothing else, it should make you realize, wow, okay, maybe it's commentary about bikinis altogether, but it's still covering the exact same amount. And all you ever get dinged for is showing nipple. It's not showing nipple. It's showing the exact percentage of a bikini before, but you're flipping out. And, you know, look, we would post bikini photos, and just because you're the one person, the only comment we got demanding that we take it down, we're not going to sit here and be like, going, look, we're not going to cater all of our content to the demands of one person. People come to our show for this kind of content. And this would be the moment where you should say, for me, this is a KVJ piece of content I don't want to absorb. And if it happens frequently, honestly, we may not be the right show for you. And you'd just be like, hey, look, they're not dialed in with the kind of content I want. But we're not going to change our show because there are a lot of people that like what we do and would expect this kind of stuff. And we're going to continue to provide that.
It just seems like irrational people are being more vocal. And they're I mean, if I was looking at it from an outside perspective, which I can't because obviously I'm in it, but I would just think she looks ridiculous. And but yet she's yelling at us that we look ridiculous and she's going to shame us and tell management. Is that where this is going?
I have an uncle, okay? I won't say what side of the family. Now, this is a guy who's insane. He is just a person that shouldn't be on social media. In fact, I don't know if he should really have a vote. He's that crazy. But if he goes on social media and posts something up and people don't know who he is, his character, his background, what he's capable of doing as a person, they're going to side with him. If he puts this big, oh, I got done wrong, and holy shit, these motherfuckers, people are going to look at that and go, oh my gosh, share it. Let's end the people that he got done wrong by. Meanwhile, my uncle's insane. He shouldn't be fucking spreading anything. Mm-hmm. See my point?
Yes. It just seems like irrational people have a voice and they are now complaining and sometimes making people get in trouble.
Poor Denny's, he really gets it the most out of it. I mean, he has to hear a lot of complaining about the shit that never even gets to us. Mm. Crazy shit.
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of it's Virginia.
Well, everybody just feels like today they can bend you to their will. And
right.
Honestly, I don't understand why people just don't see, if you don't like something, step aside.
You don't have to keep absorbing it.
Right. And, and you can't go out single-handedly and change the world and go out and lay demands saying, I demand you do this. I demand you do that. It's just, if something's not for you, back out of their way. Let people be what they're going to be and do what they're going to do. If they're not hurting you or anyone else, why do you need to step up? You got a 13-year-old son that is saying, oh, this is perverse. And he's saying that for your ears because he doesn't want you to know that he's probably home whacking it tonight. You know, so here you are. It's just, you just can't be doing this in society. These people need to stop. And people need to stop being like, oh, yes, I'm going to immediately,
I'm going to take it down because, well, one person's pissed. No.
Twitter's, I'm telling you, that's what happened. People, it's now to the point where major publications are taking somebody complaining on Twitter, putting that in their article. Then you're like, oh, my gosh, who is this person they're quoting in this article about a major issue going on in the world? You click on that person's Twitter, they've got 3 followers, and they've only been on Twitter for like 6 months.
Yeah, it's just some random individual that has zero influence. Their opinion really shouldn't carry weight, but for some reason, because it's on Twitter, it does.
It's not like a legit source. It's just someone on fucking Twitter.
Mm-hmm. Well, there you go. Interesting stuff.
Well,
I'm going to go home. I'm going to take a picture of myself in an upside down bikini and I'm going to post it on her page.
You will not do it.
This email said, hey, love you guys. Just singing it maybe during the summer. It'd be fun to have a kid edition of the No Name Movie game. I know my daughters love listening to this game and they shout like me in the car.
Aww.
I love that idea.
That is. Yeah, you do like kid movies.
I love that idea. The kids play.
That's okay. Cute. I love it.
Set it up for Friday. We'll do it. We're going to be here. Yeah. Got an email here about wedding etiquette.
Oh, boy.
Says, my fiance and I are engaged in planning a wedding. Obviously, with wedding planning, there are issues and etiquette, which is super annoying. So this is the situation. My fiance hates one of her aunts and her daughter. Last time they saw each other was Thanksgiving 2 years ago, which ended in a huge fight. And my fiance saying they are dead to her. Since then, they have literally never talked to each other, even though they live locally. It is to the point that her dad has the aunt over for Christmas Eve and we go over Christmas Day. Out of respect for her father, she begrudgingly invited both the aunt and her daughter. Now the issue is the aunt has an on-again, off-again boyfriend who's kind of a scumbag that no one really likes. The aunt is all pissy now because she does not have a plus one for her now on boyfriend. The way I see it is there are two options to handle this. Don't give her the plus one and she does not come winning, or she just comes solo since we didn't want her there in the first place. I know there is a third option of just caving and letting her bring this guy, but I know it will just upset my fiance. I know how much Jason loves wedding etiquette, and we want to see what KVJ Nation would do in this situation. Thanks so much for the insight. There you go.
I mean, I think the aunt is lucky to be going. If you have words with somebody and it ends in, you're dead to me, then you probably shouldn't expect to get an invite to a wedding with that same person. I think just the fact that she was invited with her daughter is very gracious.
Mm-hmm.
You totally were in bounds to say, you know what? I don't want my aunt there and I don't want her daughter there because it's my wedding. You can invite whoever you want and whoever you don't want to your wedding. Now, as far as a plus one, you don't give a plus one unless they're married. That's
okay.
It.
Okay, really?
You don't have
That's
to.
All right. Okay.
You certainly don't have to. And not for an on-again, off-again boyfriend that nobody cares for.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they're not even a serious fiancé situation. You don't have to give a plus one to her boyfriend.
There you go. Virginia is the expert on wedding etiquette. And she has spoken.
Is it over?
Yes. When you've been married multiple times, you get to be an expert.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you are kind of an expert. You're the expert on this show.
I'm the only one that cares.
Let's see here. We've got an email from Chris from Easton, PA. Just curious. I know Denny's had his wedding. Was there anything outside of the show that happened since you guys did not attend? Yeah, I mean, for the most part, it was pretty chill. And he also wants to know how much longer do we have to wait for a baby Den Jen? So.
Give him a little bit of time.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'd say a year or two.
Okay, all right.
She's Jen's really young still.
Yeah.
You know.
So is Denny's.
Denny's is definitely younger than you.
Most people are.
Yeah, but we didn't have, like, any big to-do or
I wasn't sure
party
if,
or anything like that.
I wasn't sure if they wanted it or not. We kind of, when they got back, he literally got off the plane and came to work, so we kind of just kind of went and hit the ground running with work again.
Do they want a party? Denny's!
Denny's!
Because if they want a party, a party they shall have.
I agree.
Get a sweet little ass in here.
Yeah.
It's so sweet.
Such a sweet ass.
Mm-hmm.
We've got some wedding questions for you.
Uh-oh.
So when you guys did your wedding and everything, we always talked about, yeah, when you get back here, we'll throw you a big party. And we never made some formal plans for said big party. Is it something you want to do?
We could open up something out to listeners to come out and hang out and have fun.
No. Is it something you want that, to do? That's the question.
I got to ask Jen if she wants to.
Okay. Yeah.
You guys tell us what you want to do because you're low-key folk.
Yeah. Super low-key.
And I know, especially Jen, it's just, it's kind of ridiculousness when
it is
all of KVJ Nation gets involved.
It is
and
a
it's
lot.
Crazy.
She's a very personal
it's party.
Person.
It's drinking. It's wild. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if it's not what she wants, we don't want to.
Yeah, totally.
Force her into a party.
Just know the option's there, baby cakes.
Yes.
And the option of not taking it is there as well.
Absolutely.
Very cool. I appreciate it.
Of course.
Okay.
We love you.
Well, you let us know. We could have a big party on the way here.
Oh, yeah. Was that the question? That was the...
Yeah.
Oh.
Yep. Calm down.
You nailed it.
I thought you said you had a couple wedding questions about that.
Well, we also kind of want you just to kind of hang out because we love you.
We do. There's a lot of love. No doubt.
Kevin's trying to read emails and still stay in the conversation.
Yeah.
A lot of excitement.
Act like he's listening.
A lot of stuff going on here.
You're busy.
Very busy. Let's see here. Lisa sent an email. She said, hey, is there going to be a Little Smiles 5K run walk this year? If so, do you happen to know when?
I don't think there will be. Last year's was so expensive to produce.
Mm-hmm.
I think that they ended up not really being happy with the way that it all turned out. We got hit with weather, and so there was a scheduling thing.
Two years in a row,
yeah. It had to be rescheduled. And I think doing the glow run thing was kind of expensive, and I think the profits weren't what they wanted it to be.
Yeah.
So I don't know. We got to always look at every event we do for Little Smiles and with Little Smiles, and weigh out the money you earn versus the volunteer hours it takes and the profit it brings.
And then they realize none of us ran.
I ran.
I ran. Well,
I ran both years.
I had a broken. Right,
you even push him in a wheelbarrow.
I ran with this dude in a wheelbarrow.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we're runners, I guess is what I'm saying.
You did good.
It's a hobby.
You're actually a good runner.
Virginia is a good runner. Yeah, she's trained a little
bit. When I train, I'm good.
She's a good runner. Shitty swimmer, but good runner.
Okay. Federica was just kind of giving some feedback. We were talking a little bit about the pitcher for Oklahoma State. He was part of the College World Series championship winning team. He's going to be off to the pros, possibly. He, at the age of 15, was accused by his six-year-old niece of molesting her. He's now, what, like 22, something like that. And so they're like, okay, was he coerced by his attorney to do it? Did he really do it? Should he be allowed to play Major League Baseball and get what would be a big paycheck considering this charge of what he's done? And Federica said, look, I've worked 4 years with minors, victims of sexual abuse. And there's a lot that the general public doesn't know about it. And I can tell you with confidence that if a child accuses somebody of sexual abuse and inappropriate sexual behavior of any kind, they are telling the truth. So children, especially younger ones, don't understand sexuality or to lie about it. I don't know who accused this guy, but if he was accused by his six-year-old niece, I can almost guarantee you that he is guilty. So there you go.
Yeah, I tend to believe the kid.
And it's typically somebody 90% close, 90% of the time, somebody done by a close family member or often a family friend, a stepdad, brother, grandfather, uncle, cousin, even a biological father. I had a few such cases. It's crazy, huh?
It's very sad.
Yeah. So anyway, some possible perspective on that. And abusers always deny unless there is pressing evidence, like the victim was left pregnant. So maybe I'm just jaded from my experience and the knowledge I have about sexual abuse, but I have zero compassion and forgiveness for abusers.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I think we're all against anybody
in agreement
that's
on that.
Yeah, abusing anybody like that.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So, yeah, it'll be interesting to see what happens with that.
How old is that six-year-old today?
Well, it was 7 years ago, so it'd be 13. I believe he's 22, around that age at least.
It'd be interesting to see what her take is now.
Well, it might be. And, you know, if he is really going to try to get a professional baseball career, if I were a team and we're even considering bringing this guy on, I'm like, for me as a general manager, I'd be like, not a chance unless these charges are refuted and we can find out that that's not the case. And that might mean trying to ask law enforcement, seeing how far we could go on that. But if there was any lingering question
for
me.
It's already done.
Yeah, then I would be like, no, it's not something we need.
Well, just alone on the business end, you don't want any kind of distraction like that whatsoever.
No.
And that is a major distraction.
Yeah,
and we need to take a stand against this and make an example of him and say, this is what can happen.
Mm-hmm.
If you're stupid and you abuse, then things aren't going to go well for you in the rest of your life. Stuff's going to fall apart. And that's just what you have to do. That's your penance.
Mm-hmm. Yep. That's pretty much it. It's an interesting story that is out about Jimmy John's delivery. How it can sometimes cause problems in your relationship. Kayla Spear wanted to do something nice for her boyfriend who lived 3 hours away and was stuck at home studying for finals. So she decided to order him a Jimmy John's sub. Isn't that nice as a girlfriend? She called the restaurant. She let him know that the food was for her man and that she wouldn't be there for the delivery. She also called her boyfriend to let him know that food was en route. When he didn't reply, she figured he was probably sleeping, tired from studying. And after a while, she finally heard back from her boyfriend thanking her for the food. And she also got a call from the delivery guy who informed her that her, quote, boyfriend had a naked lady on his couch when he dropped the food off.
Dang!
Jimmy John's confirmed the story was true, and they also offered to cater a breakup party. Dang, how about that, huh?
I'll tell you what. Jimmy John's has the quickest delivery I've ever seen in my life.
Well, that's what they push in their commercials.
They are not lying about that. Every time I order from them, they are I'm like, okay, thanks. See ya. And they're like, as soon as I hang up the phone.
It's like almost legit, huh?
I'm not kidding,
like the commercials.
It's kind of
freaky fast,
it's eerie.
Wow.
Yeah. So better be careful.
Yeah, be careful. Don't have a naked girl there in the house.
And a great idea, if you suspect your boyfriend's cheating on you, just order him a Jimmy John sub.
And send the delivery guy with marching orders to peek around when the door's open.
Yeah. By the way, can you check in on my boyfriend?
Mm-hmm. I bet delivery drivers see so much weird shit. If you've been in the game for a while.
Oh, yeah.
I think the later it gets, the weirder it's going to get.
You're right.
Oh, without a doubt. Oh, without a doubt.
That's what they always say in the Uber and Lyft cars. Like, oh, yeah, the later it gets, the weirder it becomes.
Yeah, I can imagine that. Let me see here. Got to say a little congrats. Taylor Tyson, Miss South Florida Fair 2018, was crowned Miss Florida.
Yeah.
On Saturday night in Lakeland.
Good for you.
Yeah, she's from Jupiter and a graduate from Florida Atlantic. And she is going to compete as Miss Florida in the 2019 Miss America pageant in September. In Atlantic City, competing for $55,000 in cash scholarships.
Nice.
It's kind of a cool little thing, huh? So big shout out to her and congrats. Also, a shout out here from Gator. Said, I've been listening since the wild days, and I'm now going into my junior year of college at UF. Met you guys once when I was too young to go into Dirty Martini a couple years ago, and your drunk asses came outside to say, hey.
I think I remember that.
Oh, there was so many times that would happen.
Yeah.
There he is. Jaybird recommended the tamale cakes to my boyfriend and I for our cheesecake date.
I do remember that, actually.
Yeah, I'm in Washington, D.C. for a public relations internship, so I guess you can add me to the map. Being from Stewart and growing up with the same habits as Denny's, loving food and wine and bougie life like Virginia.
That's a great picture.
Mm-hmm. Working out like a fiend and finding peace in a good sweat like Kev, and even loving a good junk binge and the supernatural like Jaybird. Let you know I'm 21 and I love Billy Joel, the Beatles, ELO, and all other amazing music.
Love this kid.
I also like Migos and all the music that you guys hate, but my generation is into. There you go.
Well, he should like both. That's I think that's the right thing.
Yeah.
Listen to the past, listen to the now.
Yep. Want to come to the next cocktails and karaoke, and you should.
That's tomorrow. No,
tomorrow?
This week.
What?
I don't know if I'm ready for it to be tomorrow.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm still a little sore from Friday.
I am sore, man. I know I look like I was in my prime, but I don't feel it.
Oh, you were dancing like a man with just the longest muscles. You were just moving. I've never seen you move like that.
That's what I'm saying. My dance moves look like I was in my prime, but internal.
The kicking, it was impressive.
Yeah, he really was... dialing it up.
I haven't seen you guys dance in a long time. It'd be nice to get your
We can't. You steal a spotlight.
I am such a stage whore.
We can't compete with that.
And I got to say what up. Got a happy 39th birthday to Kimberly's husband, Thomas. She says, you may be an asshole, but you're my asshole and the greatest dad ever.
Aww.
Love your wife, Kim, and super awesome daughter, Charlie Jade. There you go. Yeah, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
That's right.
Happy birthday. It's over.
He cut it off as soon as we started singing.
Yeah.
Damn.
Coincidence?
It's about that time, y'all. All right, well, thank you guys for tuning in. Got any comments for the KVJ Show? Just send us an email, mail@kvjshow.com, mail@kvjshow.com. We'll talk to you later. Goodbye.
Cleveland Clinic Florida provides individualized treatment plans for excellent outcomes of health problems, ranging from the most common to the most complex, even in cases considered untreatable by others. Cleveland Clinic Florida, every life deserves world-class care.